Hello and welcome inside of Platt Arena as today the Huntington University Foresters take on the Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders. Hi folks, I'm Victor McCarty alongside my partner in crime for this season, Logan Hunt. First off, Logan, how are you feeling on this very spooky Halloween snowy night? And secondly, how do you think the Foresters are going to fare this season?
Well, it's going to be a great night to open up here at the Forester Classic. And like you said, snow already on the ground on Halloween.
It's ridiculous.
That is just a shame. I'm not necessarily a fan of snow, especially this early.
Oh, yeah.
But it's going to be definitely a great matchup between the Crusaders and the Foresters. The Foresters, as you know, had a great season last year, went to the NAIA tournament. Crusaders, not as much. But the Crusaders do look to bounce back strong in this opening game. We saw last year when the Foresters took on the Crusaders, they ended up beating them 85-51. Pretty lopsided victory. The Foresters were up 41-15 to end the first half. Looking to do the same here tonight, but the Foresters definitely going to have to come out strong against the Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders.
Now, it is worthy to note, the Foresters are without two of their mainstays last year in the forms of Shane Merriman and the ever-faithful T.J. Short. T.J. Short, though, side note, he is on the coaching squad this year, so it's nice to see him back as the Foresters come in here tonight. And Shane himself, he had a great year where he was on SportsCenter quite numerous times. That was a great time to be a Forester, let me tell you what. There you go. You got it, Logan. Well, let's take a look around the league as today marks the first game of the season for the Foresters. Around the league. As you can see, it's very early in the season still. Mount Vernon has only two wins, with Spring Arbor with one. And we just saw St. Francis get a win as well here today at Forester Classic. But hey, you know, this is going to definitely change throughout the season. It's the first game of the year. But it's going to be an exciting one to boot, because the Crossroads League, I believe we sent four teams to the national tournament last year in the forms of Huntington, Iwu, Bethel, and Grace. So it'll be a very exciting year here in the Crossroads League.
Most definitely. This Crossroads League is loaded with talent. Tons of new freshmen coming in to just pack the conference. You see, like you said, out of those four teams, just tons and tons of talent to carry into the NAIA tournament. And that's what makes this league so fun. It's like watching the SEC in football, Victor. You know an upset could happen any day, any time, and that's why we play the game.
Yes, definitely. Very exciting, Logan. And real quick, let's take a look at who this year's leading scorers might be for the Foresters. In my case, because you're only a freshman, Logan, so you don't know the team as well as I do. I am a senior. In my case, I think Derek Heinen, as well as senior Alec Peterson and senior Tyler Ault, those three, as well as sophomore Daniel Wall, will do great this season for the Foresters. I can't wait to see what they have in store.
You know what? Even though I'm a freshman, I do have to agree with you. I think Derek Heinen, definitely a key contributor coming back. He led the team in assists and steals last year. You know he's going to be a big factor. And also Dan Wool, the sophomore. There's two key guys you have to watch out for.
Well, we spoke about the Foresters here on FDN Sports, but now let's get to know the team. Go ahead, director. Play the
Tyler Ault, senior, Carroll High School.
Derek Heinen, sophomore, the Columbia City High School.
Devin Murder, freshman, Heritage Hills High School.
Trevor Lockwood, freshman, McCutcheon High School.
Kyle Platt, freshman, Huntington North High School.
Daniel Wool, sophomore, the Columbia City High School.
Kai Fode, junior, Canterbury High School.
Austin Clark, freshman, Switzerland County High School.
Trevor Lucas, freshman, Brownsburg High School.
Kyle Pivinger, sophomore, Tri-Village High School.
Drew Benedict, sophomore, Columbia City High School.
Alec Peterson, senior, Carmel High School.
Calvin Miller, sophomore, Huntington North High School.
The local Calvin Miller clowning at the end of that video. This team is a very fun team, and I can't wait to see how they will perform out here on the court. We'll take a short break here on FDN Sports for the prayer, national anthem, and then we'll come right back with starting lineups. Once again, this is FDN Sports on the Forester Digital Network. And we're back here on FDN Sports looking at the starting lineups, Logan. For the Crusaders of the Great Lakes, we have Glenn James, a freshman, Jeremy Lee, freshman, Nathan Shelton, a junior, Tommy Bentley, a sophomore, and David Parks, a sophomore. Excuse me, a sophomore. Logan, what do you think about this Crusader team?
This Crusader team, they look a little undersized, to say the least, against the Foresters. The Foresters, though, do have a lot of size, but that's something that they're going to have to exploit coming out of the gate.
They do look a little small, Logan. And now for the Huntington University Foresters, for the starting lineup, we have number 2, Derek Heinen, sophomore. Number 10, Tyler Ault, the one of 2 seniors for the Forester squad. Number 34, Kyle Pippinger, a sophomore. Number 45, Daniel Wall, a sophomore. Number 33, Alec Peterson, the second of the senior squad. Logan, how do you think the Foresters are going to look here tonight?
This is a very veteran squad. All 5 starters appeared in at least 30 games or more last season. So you know they know what they're doing here, and you know that they're ready to go. We're going to see a lot of fire coming out to start.
Oh, man, it's going to be very exciting. And as I look across the court here, I see the fans. They have dressed up for this Halloween night occasion. I see some Utah Jazz players, and even the great Larry Bird is in our presence here tonight. And don't forget the ever faithful Forster fan, Dr. Shaylin Emberton. My heart just warms seeing her at every Forster game.
She's always out here, and you know that the students here love her, love what she's doing. And these, like you said, these students look riled up, ready to get going. We are ready for basketball season here at Huntington University.
And myself, I put on my ducky tie in honor of Barney Stinson. So I am excited. Logan's excited. Our whole crew's excited. Everyone at Platt Arena is excited. Let's get this done here tonight.
It's going to be a great matchup. We all know it's going to happen. Can't wait to get this thing going. And like we said, this team is very veteran. They have a lot of experience. So look for the chemistry to be there right off the bat.
Absolutely, Logan.
We're gonna see Peterson and Parks up for the tip. Peterson wins it. Heinen bringing the ball up the court. Man-to-man defense off the bat by Great Lakes. Heinen going to swing it to Alt. Going to give it right back. Heinen going to the middle to Pippinger. It's stolen away by Lee. Lee gets
Forsters
it off
to are going to have to be careful of the turnovers going on.
First score on the board there for Great Lakes as Heinen trots it up the court. Heinen gets it to Pippinger now on the right side. So now we'll see a zone defense run by Great Lakes. Pippinger on the right side for three. And that is good to start off.
Kyle Pippinger from downtown to start it off for the Foresters.
Jeremy Lee, the freshman, bringing it up. He's going to get it over to Bentley on the near side. Up Sheldon that up top. Parks the center going all the way out in the left wing to get the ball. And Wohl steals that from him easily. As Wohl will bring it up, slow things up too. Give it to Alt in the right corner. Alt tries his luck, it's not there, gets his own board. And Heinen now will reset the offense. Gets it to Alt, no look pass to Wohl down low. He's gonna be shooting too.
Two things, Logan. One, I am happy to see Mr. Kyle Pippinger in the lineup for the Foresters. He produced big numbers when he was called upon last year for the Foresters. And also, I am happy to see Mr. Derek Heinen back leading the way for the Foresters. We saw a lot of that out of him last year. But without the seniors, Shane Merriman and TJ Short gone from this squad this year, he is going to be the one to have to step up.
Most definitely, Victor. As Wohl misses his first of two free throws, that last foul was on Nathan Shelton, the junior guard. And Wohl's second free throw turned up and good. Get the first points there. Forced to take a 4-2 lead. Shelton swinging it to Bentley. Bentley to Parks. Parks for a long three. Contested nicely by Wohl. Rebound by Peterson. Bentley harassing him. Gets it to Heinen. Heinen looking to push it. Tosses it to Alt. Alt with the floater in the lane, and that is good.
On the opposite end of the court, we saw Alec Peterson getting that rebound, and I think he's going to be the guy to get those rebounds this year for the Foresters. He's been very uncharacteristic throughout the past couple years for the Foresters, but I think this will be his year, his senior year, to lead the Foresters to the victory from the rebound points.
Well, Peterson standing at 6'10", looks to dominate down low and make sure his presence is known. So now we're going to have a few substitutions for Great Lakes. We'll see Dana Thomas and Sam Anderson replacing Glenn James and Jeremy Lee.
I will say it's a little weird seeing the Foresters in green here tonight, Logan. Usually their home unis are white, but because Great Lakes brought their white jerseys, the Foresters decided to go green.
I do like the green, going green. Nothing wrong with that.
Oh, no, save the environment, Logan.
Seeing the 2-3 zone run by Great Lakes, still they're sticking to it. All gets to Pippinger on the elbow. Pippinger goes up the layup. It's not good. Offensive rebound by Wohl.
Great communication by the Foresters. When one misses, make sure the other one there is to get the points.
Anderson on the right wing as Peterson out on top. Big mismatch there. As now we're going to see Shelton go up in the lane. It's no good. Heinen getting the board, coming out quickly. Tosses off to Ault down low. Ault with the lefty layup, and that is good. Foresters out to a quick 10-2 start.
After a rocky start with that first turnover leading to the Great Lakes points, the Foresters are having their way with the Crusaders.
Man-to-man defense being run by the Foresters. Anderson on that left side with Peterson. Picks up his dribble. Gets it to Shelton now. Shelton out to Thomas. Thomas picks up the dribble, long three, and that is good.
It was great defense by number two, but good job by Great Lakes number 10, getting the ball over Heinen and in for the three.
Heinen, little dish to Wool. Wool right back to Heinen for the three.
We might have a dish of anything you can do, I can do better here tonight, Logan.
Thomas gets it up court, going to get screened there from Parks. He's going to take a long two, and it gets an air ball there, and they're going to say that the ball went out of bounds first. Forster basketball. A little confusion there, but they are saying that after the air ball, it touched the baseline there, so it's going to be Forster basketball.
It was good effort by Wall, trying to keep the ball in play, but Forster ball anyway.
Coach Platt calling out the play. Heinen walks it up for the Foresters. Pippinger receives it down the left corner. Gets it back to Heinen. And all good ball movement here by the Foresters. Gets it to Peterson down low. He misses the lefty layup, but gets his own rebound and puts it in.
Just the slightest touch can be the difference in a game. Great job by Alec Peterson getting his rebound back for the two.
We see Wool coming up with another steal and putting the moves there on Jeremy Lee. Finally gets it up to Heinen. Heinen getting to Ault in that left wing for three. No good. Rebound by Alec Peterson on the offensive board. And he will be pushed. Going to be a foul there on Great Lakes. That one is going to be on Sam Anderson. That's the team second. We're going to have a quick media timeout here, but we're going to stay right here. So far, Victor, we've seen the Foresters come out hot. They're up 15-5 already to start the game. What have you seen so far out of the Foresters that you like?
Well, the one thing that I definitely like from the Foresters here tonight in Platt Arena is the hustle. You can never have too much hustle, and I love seeing that here tonight from the Foresters. In past, early in the season, you might not get that, but I love seeing the effort here tonight by the Foresters. For instance, Alec Peterson getting those boards and making sure he gets his points, doing his job as a senior, leading this team to get the points.
Alec Peterson, like you said, crashing the offensive rebound. We've seen Dan Wool defensively already picked up two steals. He's had an offensive putback of himself. And like we said, Foresters just coming out quick and ready to go. Derek Heinen has done his job. Ault Pippinger coming out, landing the first points of the ball game. So far, it seems like the Huntington Foresters are just cool and collected, maybe have rattled Great Lakes Crusaders just a little bit to start this ball game, and that's exactly what they want to do. Coming out of this timeout, Great Lakes going with a few new bodies. And we're going to see Kyle Pippinger on the baseline looking to inbound from underneath his own basket. Gets it to Ault in the corner, out to Heinen. Heinen swings it back to Ault, thought about the shot, gets it down low to Peterson. And Peterson with a walk of his own. Looks like a little bit of contact there. Drew his balance off just a little bit to cause that extra third step.
And going forward, Logan, Peterson will have to watch on the fouls on himself, because in the past years he has had some unfortunate fouls against himself, and he's fouled out many times where the Foresters needed him at the most.
We see Great Lakes trying to work it down low to David Parks. It's not there. Wool with another steal. He's going to try to go coast to coast. Now dishes it off to Heinen. Heinen to Ault. Ault to Wool. Morris going to get back to Hines. He's going to reset the offense. Bulls in that, in the money spot there from the zone. Couldn't quite handle the pass. It's going to be Sean Colton taking it. He's going to finally dish it off to Juwan Williams with a miss. Up and in, that's no good. Wall with the rebound. Heinen looking to run. That's Peterson in front of him as a lead blocker. Pulls it back out, though. Now he goes with the no-look down low to Peterson, and Peterson up and in.
And one for the Foresters.
Great and one opportunity there. Nice ball control by Derek Heinen, is just taking his time, very under control. And like you said, finding Alex Peterson, who will be crucial. So now we're going to have a substitution for your Foresters. Coming in will be Drew Benedict replacing the senior Tyler Ault.
And you might not know this, Logan, but now we have the CC3, as I like to call them, the Columbia City 3, out on the court. Derek Heinen, Drew Benedict, and Daniel Wall.
Also coming in will be Austin Clark, the freshman replacing Alex Peterson. Austin Clark has some size of his own, 6'6". From Switzerland County High School and put up great numbers as a junior, averaging 18 points a game. So expect a lot out of him as a Forester.
I will have to say, Logan, even though the Foresters lost Shane Merriman this year, I think they gained 5 Shane Merrimans in the form of their freshman class. We have a very big freshman class.
5 freshmen coming in. They call themselves the Fab Five. We'll see what they can do. As the Foresters getting going here, Heinen going to Benedict. Benedict, a key three-point shooter. Led the team in three-point field goal percentage last year at 43%. Pippinger going to try to drive, and he gets pushed out of bounds, and that will be a foul on Great Lakes. I believe that's going to be on Sean. They're going to call that on Sam Anderson, excuse me. As now we have another substitution. This one will be Devin Murder coming in for Kyle Pippinger. Devin Murder, another one of these talented freshmen. He comes from Santa Claus, Indiana, Heritage Hills High School. Some of you may know Santa Claus, Indiana is where Holiday World is.
It is indeed, Logan. I think we're almost in Holiday World here tonight with the snow outside, but it being Halloween on the inside.
Turnover there by Benedict. That's going to be Jalen Adams getting it. Dishes it off now to Williams, and that rolls out. Clark with the rebound. Heinen looks up. Nothing working. He's going to bring it up himself. Gets it to Murder in the corner. He's just going to get it right back out to Heinen. Heinen back to Murder in the corner. Murder decides he's going to take the three, and it's no good. Rebound by Jalen James. James going to try to take it. Gets it back out to Williams. Williams trying to break down Benedict, but to no avail. And now they're going to call a hand check foul on Drew Benedict. That'll be his first foul of the ball game. Now be the team's first also. As now we have another substitution. Kyle Platt enters the game for Dan Woolham. Platt, as we know, is the son of Coach Platt.
That is an interesting situation, Logan, having the coach have to coach his own son.
We've seen it work before in college basketball, and they're going to try to do it again. As now we have a long three-point attempt by Bentley. Just attaches the rim. And they get the rebound here, and the Foresters will take a 30-second timeout with 13:06 remaining. The Huntington Foresters lead this one 18-7, and they've come out strong, and they have not looked back from any bit of timeouts. Victor, we've seen a lot. We've seen a lot of Foresters play so far. We've seen a few freshmen. Seen Clark, Platt, and Murder all get in. What do you like of this rotation?
Well, that's what I love about it being early in the season, is that a majority of their team gets a lot of time, and that will be an effective play calling going on to the future. As we've learned here in the past, the Crossroads League is a very competitive league, and you're going to need all the members of your team that you can get.
Heinen going to get the inbound. Gets it off to Platt in the right wing. Gets it back to Platt now in the corner. Clark in the free throw line. Gets it over to Benedict. Murder swinging it back to Benedict on the left side. Heinen going to get it up top. Breaking down his man. tip pass is going all around down low, and Clark comes up with it, puts it up and in for an and one opportunity.
Another and one for the Foresters. Great Lakes are going to have to be careful. They're already down 20-7. If they want to stay in this game, they can't commit the fouls.
That foul will be on Sean Colton. That's his first foul, and the team's sixth. So next foul, the Foresters will be shooting the one and one. They'll be in the bonus. As we'll see, Clark's and one opportunity up and in. Great Lakes pressing it up court. Foresters still going to their man-to-man defense. Look, this will be David Parks getting it over to Bentley. Bentley back to James, has Benedict all over him. Parks with the long three, contested nicely by Clark. It's not there. Platt with the rebound. He brings it up, dishes off to Heinen. Heinen to Murder. Murder back to Heinen at the top of the key. That's going to be a steal there for DeJuan Williams. He goes up in the easy layup.
I love to see this effort out of this Crusaders squad, getting the steal, and also, though, I will have to say, they have to be a little more attentive around the rebound in order to stay into the game.
Heinen putting the moves there on Williams, makes him fall but couldn't quite convert. Benedict going to get the long rebound. Benedict going to take a long three now himself, and he splashes that home.
Get used to seeing that, Logan. He did that all last season.
Will be Williams, bringing it up, gets it to Park. Clark all over him. Great Lakes trying to move the ball quickly. Now it'll be Williams taking the shot, not there. Heinen getting it, pushing up court. Gets it off to Benedict. Benedict, same spot for three. It's not there. Platt with the rebound, and he's going to pull it back out. He'll find Heinen as they reset. Heinen going with the Rondo look, fake pass, back out to Platt for three, and Platt gets one of his own.
So far, Platt's showing that he can do it all. He can not only get the rebounds, but he can go outside and get the threes.
Kyle Platt led Huntington North High School in three-point field goal percentage, holds the record for the career. He shot 47% for career three-point percentage at Huntington North High School and holds the record for season field goal percentage at 53.5%.
That's outstanding for a big man, Logan.
Say, Platt stands at 6'6", every bit as tall as his father, and he's showing why maybe he can catch up with his father's records here at Huntington.
That would be great to see.
As the Foresters have come out swinging, hitting multiple threes, they lead 27-9 with 11:06 remaining in this first half. Great Lakes going to have to put together some runs here, as now we'll see Trevor Lucas, another freshman, in the ball game. He'll let Derek Heinen take a seat. So we have four freshmen on the court for the Foresters. Benedict, the only sophomore. There comes Williams, dishing out to Parks. Parks taking the long three, and that's not there. Platt with the rebound, gets it to Murder. Murder getting up court quickly to Benedict. Benedict out to Murder. We're going to see Murder run a little bit of the point. Murder getting the play call from Platt, as Lucas is going to take it to the hole, dish out now to Murder for three. Murder in the corner, no good. Rebound by Bentley. Bentley going to get it up quickly to James. James gets it to Park. Park going to find Bentley on the left elbow. It's not there. Murder with the rebound. Murder goes to Platt. Platt for a wide open three from the wing, and that's good. As Great Lakes looking to press, Williams going full length. Can't quite get that layup. Platt with the rebound. He's going to get it to Murder.
St. Francis in attendance in the audience tonight as they take part in the Forester Classic. And I think they're taking note of this young Kyle Platt as he's doing it all tonight for the Foresters.
Kyle Platt seems to be on fire. We see Murder getting a few points of his own, getting himself in the box score. This one will be Jalen James now trying to break down Benedict. It's not there. Good switch by the Foresters. Williams going to take it into that left side, up and in, and that will be good. Murder bringing the ball up for your Foresters. Man-to-man defense now by Great Lakes. They've switched out of that zone from the hot shooting Foresters, hitting all those threes. Lucas does the no-look pass down low to Clark, and Clark will be hit on the back of his head and fouled, and he will be going to the line to shoot two. as that foul will be on David Parks, the sophomore from Michigan. And that will be his second foul. Clark looking to drill his first free throw attempt here. And he misses this one. As now we're going to have a few substitutions for the Forcers. Drew Benedict and Devin Murder will take a seat. And for them will be Calvin Miller and Kai Fode.
Two other hometown heroes here in Huntington.
Fode from Canterbury and Miller from Huntington North, like you said, Victor. Clark missing both free throws, not very typical for him. As Williams going to try to break down Lucas, he gets it in, and good for two. Lucas looking to press for the Forsters. He finds Miller in the corner. Miller thought about the shot. Goes to Lucas. Lucas up and in for left. It's not there. Can't get his own rebound. That will be Sean Carlton. Granted up, but Lucas comes from behind and picks his pocket and puts the moves on him. As Trevor gets it to Calvin Miller for three, and from the corner, that rims around and out. Rebound by David Parks as he's going to try to bring it up himself for the Crusaders. Backdoor cut to Sean Carlton. A beautiful play there by the Crusaders for an easy 2 points as they seem to be getting themselves back into this ballgame. 32-15. Forster still on top. Lucas going to dish off to Platt on the left wing. Platt looking down low to Clark. Finally gets it to him on the left block. Isolation for Clark on Parks. He goes with the spin move. Couldn't quite get the left layup. Gets his own rebound. Goes up and going to be called for a charge. That will be Sean Carlton setting his feet and getting Clark with the offensive foul. Now the Clark's first foul of the ball game and the team's second. As now we'll see Platt, Clark, and Lucas all take a seat. And now for your force should be Derek Heinen, Dan Wool, and Trevor Lockwood, the final fifth freshman to get into this ball game. We've seen every single Forster on the roster get into this game now.
That's one thing that I love to see. I love to see every member of a team getting time out on the court.
You see Williams being guarded by Fode. Now Wool's up top with James. Williams going with his quickness on Fode and gets it into that left side for a layup. Heinen bringing the ball up for the Foresters. Goes to the left block to Wool. Wool back out to Heinen. Heinen going to take it in with the floater. It's no good. And Heinen will be fouled, and he will be shooting two. As that foul will be on Jeremy Lee. That's Lee's first foul in the team's seventh. But we have a timeout on the floor. This will be a media timeout. Your Foresters lead 32-17 over the Great Lake Crusaders. Victor, this is the very first game for the Foresters. And so far, you would expect that they were ready for conference play. As we said, that the Crossroads League is so tough, and I think they could play with anyone right now.
Absolutely, Logan. I am loving the way we see them play here tonight. We have the Foresters, every member of the team, getting in so far. The freshmen, they've showcased their skills at a great deal of efficiency. I have loved what I've seen out of Kyle Platt, son, as we've noted, of the coach, Mr. Ty Platt, and as well a hometown hero for the Huntington North Vikings. And don't forget to follow us on FDN Sports at FDN Sports on Twitter and Forster Digital Network on Facebook. I am doing the best I can to tweet and commentate during the game. But getting back on track here, again, I am loving what I'm seeing out of the freshman squad. It's definitely a promising future for the Foresters.
Like you said, there are five freshmen for the Foresters that seem to be able to play with the big boys already. They've graduated from high school ball, and they're ready for this NAIA college basketball, complimenting the team well. Got to tip your hat to Coach Hotchkiss, who does the main recruiting for this Huntington University squad. He's done a great job bringing in some guys. And next year, are you already looking forward to next year? There's already three commits, two of them. Got two twin brothers. You got the Rutland brothers coming in from Cecina Mora High School. Great two guards there. And also Mason Coverstone, who has a great three-point shot from Columbia City. You can see another Columbia City guy coming here.
And that will only build with the Foresters' chemistry, getting a guy that three of the guys have already played with.
Exactly. As we see Heinen splashing his second free throw attempt, missing on the first to extend the lead to 15 for the Foresters. This will be Glenn James bringing it up. He finds Jalen James on the left side. Thomas going to get it up top. So we see a lot of motion offense being run by the Crusaders. Good switches being called out by the Foresters. We see a long three by James. No good. Rebound by Pippinger. Gets it off to Hennon. Hennon going strong to the right side. Going to find Lockwood. Lockwood looking to pass immediately. Gets it back to Hynen. Hynen with a little give and go to Wool. Gets it to Lockwood. And Lockwood goes up and will be fouled.
With Trevor Lockwood wearing that iconic number 55 jersey here in Platt Arena, he kind of reminds me of a young Shane Merriman. I am going to love to see that in future years.
They both have the curly hair, both about 6'8". Got to think it's going to be possibly the same player, hopefully, for the Foresters. We see Lockwood splash his first free throw in. Just to mention, that was the third foul on David Parks for the Crusaders, so he will have to sit. And for him will be Sean Calton as Lockwood drills the second one. Bringing up the core will be Thomas for the Crusaders. Williams at the top of the key. Losing control a little bit. Finds James on the right side. Back to Lee up top. Calvin Miller all over him. Thomas taking it in on Pippinger. And it's going to be a foul, I believe, on Kyle Pippinger. And that will allow Dana Thomas to shoot two.
Kyle Pippinger a little overzealous for the Foresters, but it's all right. Still early in the game, still first half, 6:45 left to go.
Thomas' first free throw attempt is up and good. As now we'll see him go for this second one. Second one is up, and he gets both of them. Heinen going to bring it up for your Foresters. He gets a nice jog getting it up court. Still man-to-man defense being run by the Crusaders. Dishes off to Pippinger on that right wing. He gets it back to Heinen at the top of the key. Sets a screen for him. Heinen going down low to Lockwood. Lockwood up and in for the slam.
I tell you what, Logan, that is the first slam dunk I have seen for the Foresters in an opening game.
And who would have... have to come from number 55, the freshman, Trevor Lockwood.
Hey, we said it's Halloween night. We might have the ghost of Shane Merriman in number 55 jersey.
We'll see. Lockwood inbound it now to Heinen. Heinen getting it up now to Miller on the left wing. Miller out to Pippinger at the top of the key. Little jump step. Goes up with the floater. And that's good. He's going to go to the line for an and one.
Another and one for the Foresters.
They just keep coming and coming. The Foresters are just going to have to convert now. There are going to be a few substitutions now for Great Lakes. We'll see Sam Anderson and Glenn James come into the ball game. As so far, no rotation seems to be working for Great Lakes. The Foresters just seem to be too strong for them. Pippinger, great free throw shooter. Shot 85% on the year last year. Led the team in free throw percentage. Converts the end one. Typical for Kyle Pippinger.
And I think that's one of the reasons why Platt has made him a starter this year, is because when he gets fouled, he makes the shots, and that's a key point for any basketball team.
Pippinger looking to be a key contributor this year. He got in 30 games last year. Didn't do as much. We saw a lot of his defense come into play, but now we're seeing his scoring ability. And on this end of the court, we're going to see an illegal screen. Now get the Foresters possession. 10 fouls on Great Lakes, so the Foresters are in the double bonus. They'll shoot two free throws on any foul. Wool trying to go down low, and he's going to be tripped, so he will be going to the line to shoot two. That foul is going to be on Glenn James, the freshman from Detroit, Michigan. Dan Wool going to the line to shoot a pair of free throws. Last year, he was 58% on the year. First one's up and good.
It is worth noting, Logan, that this Great Lakes Christian College team have no seniors on their squad. So they do lack a little leadership right now, but I do like the effort that they have shown so far in this game.
We'll see Lockwood and Miller take a seat. Peterson and Alt come in, and Peterson almost grabbing the offensive rebound off the miss. Not quite, as feisty Sean Carlton gets it, takes the whole length, and he gets himself a two. His toe was on the line. And now the head referee gonna switch the decision, gonna switch the call, and say that Carlton was indeed behind the line, and they're gonna call him for a three. Heinen bringing the ball up for the Forsters. Just over 5 minutes left to go in this first half. The Forsters lead 41-22. Alt gonna go down low to Peterson. Peterson working his way around down low in the paint to get up and in for an easy two.
It's a great job by Peterson, finding a way. Where there's a will, there's a way, and it was a great will by Peterson.
Williams going down. Gets a nice clear lane to get in an easy two. Peterson almost coming over to hit the block, but not quite there.
Three threaded the needle up the middle.
Wool getting the ball down low against an undersized Carlton who tries to flop. It's not there. Wool up and in for an easy two, and he's going to get the and one.
I got to watch myself, Logan. I can't say these tongue twisters throughout the game.
Wool going to the line for an and one opportunity. That foul going on to Juan Williams, another freshman, and this team is flooded with freshmen. And Wool's and one opportunity up and good. And we'll see Williams bringing up quickly for Great Lakes. He's going to throw way out to the volleyball line to Jalen James at the top of the key. He's going to drive in hard. It's not there. Oh, with some great defense there on James. It's no good. Heinen coming out with the ball. He gets up the four quickly. He's going to go up, go behind the back to Wool. Wool going back down to Hennen. Now Alt at the top of the key with the ball. Spin move in the lane. Up, not there. Peterson almost getting the ball, not quite. As you're going to see Glenn James just throw the ball up court, trying to get it to Jalen James, and that was not there.
As I noted, Logan, this Great Lakes team, they're a young squad, so they might not have scouted the Foresters or might not have had the experience from the prior years facing them. You have to know, don't lob up the ball when Daniel Wall is right there. He could have easily stolen that ball, ran it back to get easy points for the Foresters.
We've seen Wall already with two steals tonight, and that could have just tacked on to make his box score look a little nicer already. You see Pippinger getting the ball on the wing. Gets it to Wool. Pippinger getting the give and go down low, and he will be fouled going up for two. Pippinger will be at the line shooting two. And that foul will be on Glenn James. That will be his third foul. Remember, it's five fouls here in college basketball, and you are DQ'd, so Glenn James is going to have to watch out. But looks like Coach Piercefield for the Crusaders is going to keep him in. Decision time, deciding to keep him in. As Pippinger going to go for this second free throw attempt. That one's up and in. Routine for Kyle Pippinger. See Williams bring it up, using his speed to dish off now to James. James with the two. It's not quite there, mid-range. Anderson getting the board. He's going to go up for two. It's not there. Hennen finally getting the rebound, nice and strong. Hennen going with a spin move in the lane and up for an easy right-hand layup.
Great moves by the sophomore, Derek Heinen.
Williams getting a couple of screens now. Tyler Alt going to switch over to him. Carlton going with the long three. It's not there. Peterson coming up with the rebound. Heinen going to go to Alt on the fast break. Alt with the reverse layup. Not quite there. Wool almost coming up with it. Gets it to Peterson. Peterson goes up for two. It's not there. So we have bodies on the floor. That's Sam Anderson. And finally, the Foresters get it to Pippinger. Pippinger goes up for two. And he's going to get another and one opportunity.
This game's looking like it's being played in a backyard, Logan. Very reminiscent of street ball playing tonight in Platt Arena.
Street ball indeed is what it looks like, but the Foresters seem to be winning that game. as we'll see, Dan will exit the ballgame. And for him will be the freshman, Austin Clark. Pippinger free throw attempts up, and that is good. Forsters extending their lead now, 53-24 with 2:45 remaining in this first half. Shelton gets the ball on that right side. Spin move on Pippinger. He gets stuffed down low. Going to try to get to James. James going to try to force his way in on Clark. It's not there. Clark with the easy rebound.
I love this young Austin Clark for the Foresters. Not only did he have his hands up in a great defensive performance, but he was able to get the rebound.
And up at the top of the key. Thought about shooting sides against it. This time he's going to drive. Goes up. And it's not quite there. Clark getting the rebound. He gets up and in for two. As once again we see Sam Anderson trying to get a charge, but to no avail. Now this will be Colton bringing the ball up for Great Lakes. Going to dish off to Williams. Williams doing a little ISO for himself on hitting. Not quite there. Clark with the rebound. And it gets it to Pippinger. Pippinger looked down low to Peterson. Not quite there. Heinen going to get it back up top. Swings it over to Alt in the right wing. Down low now to Clark. Clark spin move, and he will be fouled. So Clark will be going to the line to shoot two. We see yet another foul on Glenn James. That is his fourth.
I wouldn't say it'd be a negative thing that the Foresters continue to go to the line, because that is a good practice for the future of being able to hit the free throws, as we see Austin Clark miss his first.
We'll see Kyle Platt, Devin Murder, and Drew Benedict all back in this ball game. We'll see Kyle Pippinger, Derek Heinen, and Tyler Alt taking a seat, a well-deserved seat for the Foresters. Clark's second free throw attempts up, and that is no good. Peterson with the board. He goes up for a strong two, and that is good.
As I said before, Logan, that in the past we wouldn't have seen Alec Peterson perform at this level that he is tonight, putting that extra effort forward to get the rebound and get the two for the Foresters. But this year, as a senior, he is showing a tremendous form of effort.
Murder getting himself in a little bit of trouble, but Platt getting it back. As now we're going to have an official's timeout. This will be something wrong with the clocks, with the official thought. So he's going to try to discuss it now with the head referee. On the floor for your Foresters, you have Benedict, Peterson, Clark, Murder, and Platt. Three highly touted freshmen that seem to be exerting their will so far tonight. And like you can see on the court, the Foresters just look bigger in every single matchup. It seems like the Foresters have this size, and we've seen Alec Peterson use it tremendously so far tonight. He has a couple of offensive rebounds and putbacks.
It is a big height difference for the Foresters. I think they're taking their name to heart and being the trees in the forest.
Very good reference there, as we see Murder going all the way to the lane with the left-handed layup, and that is good. Jalen James trying to push the ball. Gets it up to Bentley. Bentley going to go down low to Buger, but Peterson was right there with his big hand. And Murder losing the ball now. And that's going to be Lee coming up with it. He gets, looks like, swatted by Platt. Platt may have got a hand on that. As now the Foresters are pressing. Benedict thought about shooting, gets it to Murder, running the court. It's not there. Peterson up and in for two, getting another offensive rebound putback.
That was a good job by Kyle Platt earlier in the play. Seeing that, Devin Murder, his teammate, was in trouble, getting back, blocking the shot, and points for the Foresters.
So now we're going to see a foul called on the Huntington Force. That one's going to be on Kyle Platt. That'll be his first foul and the team's fourth of this half. We see 45 seconds remaining in this first half, and the Foresters only have four fouls. They've done a great job of keeping themselves out of foul trouble. To the line will be Jalen James. He'll be shooting two. First one up, off the front iron and out. Now Trevor Lockwood will enter the ball game for Alex Peterson. Lockwood Didn't have too bad of a high school career himself. He averaged 14 points, 9 rebounds, and 6 blocks a game.
Well, you know those Indiana boys. It's Hoosier Nation, and we are, what's the number one thing we're known for besides racing? Basketball.
And corn. As we see Devin Murder bringing the ball up against Danny Buger. He gets it up with ease.
Let's try to break the stereotype, Logan. All right? There's more than just corn in Indiana.
Austin Clark on the block down low. He's going to go up for 2. He's going to get it blocked by Lee. And Lockwood comes with the ball. He's going to miss. Rebound now by Bentley. As Clark goes for the steal on Bentley, tips it away, but Bentley's able to keep possession. And that will be Lee getting himself a right-handed layup up and in. 10 seconds now as Murray bringing the ball up, gets it to Platt. Platt bringing it up as his father is yelling at him, saying, "Son, let's go," as Platt misses the right-handed layup. Jalen James going for the full court shot. It is not there. And that is how that first half will end. The Huntington Foresters leading 61-27 over the Great Lakes Crusaders.
Yes, it was a great performance by the Foresters here in the first half against the Crusaders of the Great Lakes Christian College. Awesome performance so far the Foresters. What is the number one thing you have liked out of the Foresters so far tonight?
I've liked the hustle that I've seen out of all the Foresters. Even with some of the few missed shots, you've seen at least 3 or 4 Foresters crashing the boards, and particularly Alex Peterson down low. You've also seen Trevor Lockwood, Dan Will. They've really been getting at it and really been doing just a fantastic job just crashing the boards, getting easy putbacks.
Yes, Logan, I will have to agree with you. This is FDN Sports on the Forester Digital Network. We'll be right back with the second half of the Huntington University Foresters versus the Great Lakes Christian College.
Look at you, man. First year, looking sharp. Looks good. The video looks great. Are we doing wireless? We're doing wireless?
It's like a second place. It's hard to cut back.
He has a little bit of a delay.
It's not a second. So, like,
we were told there wasn't that kind of a delay. We got a
camera one on here, so it's the same delay.
We'll have to look into that. We were told there would not be a delay. We have fast speed internet coming to us.
Thank you. Thank you.
And we're back here inside Platt Arena tonight as the Huntington University Forcers take on the Crusaders from the Great Lakes Christian College. Hi, folks. I'm Victor McCarty alongside my partner in crime, Logan Hunt, as we take a look at the halftime stats from these two teams. Logan?
As you can see, the Foresters came out hot, shooting 52%. Great Lakes shooting only 32%. From the free throw line, though, Great Lakes only took 4 free throw attempts compared to the Foresters' 19. However, Great Lakes shot 75%. The Foresters shot 63%. But the Foresters did win the battle at the three-point.
One stat that does surprise me is that Great Lakes has one more block than the Foresters, even though the Foresters have the taller squad here tonight. So that's a surprising stat for me. But turnovers, we see that is plaguing both teams. More importantly, plaguing the Crusaders.
Most definitely. I think that is what's held Great Lakes out of this game so far. Besides the hot hand from about every single Forester there is, you've seen Pippinger knock down a couple of long threes. Benedict got himself going. Platt coming out strong. Great Lakes has only have one man in double digits. That's DeJuan Williams. He has 10 points for Great Lakes. Forster sporting two guys already in double figures. That's Alex Peterson and Kyle Pippinger.
And that is another thing that I would like to say, once again, as I said in the first half, is that the freshmen for the Foresters, are doing a tremendous job here tonight, with Kyle Platt sticking out the most for me.
Platt did a great job there. Offensively, like you said, he came out hot. I believe that Kyle Pippinger came out with the intensity. He led the way for the Foresters. He has this look on his face that he never shows quite any emotion, but he's kind of like a Tracy McGrady type.
That is true, Logan. After spending some time with him in the dorms last year, he pretty much has the same expression on all the time.
He hits a three, and he just smirks and runs back on defense. And I think that caught some people off guard when he came out here shooting so well and getting so many and-one opportunities. He's already had 4 free throw attempts and hitting all 4.
But I like to see that in a player, because sometimes when a player shows too much emotion, that gets the best of them, and that takes them out of the game. From what I've seen with Pippinger, his head is always in the game.
Definitely. And someone else who has their head in the game would be Alex Peterson. He has already racked up 7 rebounds, 5 of them on the offensive glass. He's done his job so far. And also his substitutes coming in for him, you have Austin Clark and Trevor Lockwood, the two freshmen splitting time as kind of the backup center. They're doing a fantastic job themselves.
Absolutely, Logan. Once again, this is FDN Sports on the Forester Digital Network. Tremendous job by the Foresters in the first half. And during halftime, we saw the students take part in a little costume competition. That's always great to see from the Foresters. But right now, we'll take a break and be right back with the second half action of Foresters versus the Crusaders here inside Platt Arena.
Underway here to start this second half of play. The Foresters on top 61-27. We see Parks taking a long three from the right wing. Rebound from Alt. He gets it off to Heinen. Heinen bringing it up court quickly. Down low to Peterson. Goes up with the left hand. Kent gets it. Gets his own rebound and puts it back in for 2. We'll see Colton bringing it up quickly. Not quite there. Parks on top the key. Peterson meets him out there. It's going to be Pippinger getting the steal, going behind the back, and he drives in with a floater. Great play there from Kyle Pippinger.
Pippinger looks like Michael Jordan out of Space Jam right there, let me tell you what.
Ah, it looked like he jumped from the free throw line.
Exactly. Stretch it out.
Now it's going to go down low to Bentley with the left hand. He's able to kiss that one off the glass.
This ain't Valentine's Day, Logan. It's Halloween. No kissing today. All right.
We'll have that once February comes. As we see, I didn't get it over to Ault. Ault going to go on the free throw line to Wool. Wool going to go in strong to the right side, and he gets that one to roll in for him. And now Colton brings it up on the right wing. He's going to go down low to Bentley. Bentley throws crazy pass out to Williams. Heinen going to get credit with the steal. He's going to put that up and in for an easy two.
As I mentioned in the first half, the Crusaders have to be careful with their turnovers, because as we've seen so far tonight, if they turn over the ball, a Forster, or lose possession of the ball, a Forster is always there to get it and capitalize.
Colton with the shot from the elbow. It's not there. Heinen getting the board. He's looking up court for something quick. He's going to take it himself on the right side. Good box out by Wool to give him the clear lane, and that's going to be an and-one opportunity for Derek Heinen. Heinen perfect on the night so far from the free throw line. One for one, looking to get himself another and-one opportunity. And he converts on the and-one. It'll be Jeremy Lee swinging it up to DeJuan Williams. William leads the team in scoring so far. He swings it to Colton on the left wing. Parks has it out on the right wing. He's going to take a long three, and finally Parks gets one to fall for him. He was 0 for 3 on the night until that last one.
Number 30 of the Crusaders trying to give some life for Great Lakes team.
It's a long three-point attempt for him. As Pippinger gets the ball on the right wing, dribbles with his left hand. Going to go down low out of Peterson. Peterson swings it out to Ault. Ault going to drive in. He goes up for two, and that is good. Colton gets it up court quickly. He's going to find Williams. Williams has Heinen all over him.
Great job by Heinen closing in.
Parks with the spin move and kisses that one off the glass from the left elbow.
30 capitalizing on Peterson losing his balance and not being able to block the shot.
See Ault with the ball now on the right wing. Gets it back up top to Heinen. Heinen goes to Pippinger on the left side. Pippinger just gets it right back to Heinen. Heinen going to cut back to his left. Going to go up with the right hand in the lane, and that is good.
He loses the ball, but he's still able to score. Crusaders having a tough time stopping the Foresters here tonight.
Colton goes up for a hard two. Wool all over that one. Pippinger gets himself a rebound. He's going to take it up himself. That's a spin move out about half court. He's going to go in. No look pass to Wool. Wool goes up for two. It's not there. Gets his own rebound and finishes.
If there's one thing that I've learned over the years in the sport of basketball, is you cannot leave a lane open. And that's what the Crusaders just did.
That lane was wide open. It looked like Moses had parted the seas for him. As Wool gets the rebound off the long miss from Williams, he's going to take it the full length of the court. Loses his dribble, somehow gets it back in the corner. Going to find Peterson down low. Peterson looks for the give and go, not quite there. And now we're going to have a blocking foul on Derek Heinen as Jeremy Lee took it right to his chest. And now we're going to have our first media timeout. And it looks like coming out of this timeout that the Foresters are going to go for a whole new look.
They're going to clear the bench and bring out those fresh faces in the freshmen.
Definitely, this is a game that you would want to be in if you are a freshman, and even if someone in the kind of the 12th man of the rotation, you're going to get a lot of playing time. As Foresters have a 78-34 lead so far over Great Lakes.
One thing I would like to discuss, Logan, is the atmosphere here tonight in Platt Arena. Even though it is Halloween, we have a lot of people here, and I think that's due in part because of the weather outside. No one wants to go trick-or-treating. They'd rather avoid the trick of the weather outside and come inside to have the treat and watching the Foresters play the Crusaders here tonight.
That is definitely true. Don't see too many children in the building. There are a few. They must have cut their trick-or-treat time short already.
And reminder, this timeout, this media timeout, is brought to you by the Huntingtonian. We are the news. You can follow the Huntingtonian at Huntingtonian on Twitter. And, of course, follow all of their news updates on the Huntingtonian Facebook.
Coming out of the timeout, we're going to see Kyle Platt, Austin Clark, Calvin Miller, Devin Murder, and Drew Benedict all in for the Forsters. This seems to be the typical second unit. And now we're going to have Sean Colton to inbound. He gets it to DeJuan Williams. Williams goes to Colton. Colton trying to drive, finds Parks in the right wing, open for three. That hits the front iron. No good. Rebound, though, by Jeremy Lee, but Platt with the rejection. Anderson comes up with it, shoots a long three, and that goes in.
Platt has been rebounding, he's been blocking, he's been shooting from three. I don't know what this kid can't do.
We see Benedict now, gets it to Platt, top of the key, he's going to find Murder on the right wing. Good motion run by the Forsters as Miller finds himself at the elbow. He gets it to Clark, Clark to Murder for three, and that one doesn't quite fall. Rebound by Parks. Parks going to bring it up himself. He's going to shoot a long three from the top of the key. That's no good. Calvin Miller with the rebound, and he'll bring it up himself. He gets it to Benedict. Benedict down low to Clark. Clark with a spin move on the inside. Goes with a reverse layup. It's not there.
That's three missed shots in a row for Austin Clark.
And that will be DeJuan Williams getting the rebound, taking it the full length of the court. And he'll get that one to fall with an and-one opportunity for himself. As Williams seems to be the only life that this Great Lakes squad has so far.
It is nice seeing them show so much life here in the second, being down by as much as they are. I would like to have a little bit more, you know, competition going forward here in the game.
Williams looking to convert on his and one opportunity. Hasn't been to the free throw line yet tonight, but he gets that one to fall. So we'll see Devin Murder, the 6'4 freshman, bringing it up court, who he has the likes of a Derek Heinen in himself. He's going to find Benedict for a long three from the right wing. It's no good. That one rims out. That's going to be a rebound for Sean Colton, and he will get fouled.
Fouled by Austin Clark as he was just down on the court, and he couldn't get up as the Crusader ran into him.
Inbound now goes to Williams. Man-to-man defense being run by the Foresters. Williams is going to find Jalen James. He gets it to Anderson on the right side. Anderson with the hop step. Goes for the long two. It's not there. Rebound by Calvin Miller. And Miller trying to get a little fancy with it. Not quite there. Stolen away by Great Lakes as James goes up for two. And that's
it. I love the press that I just saw from the Crusaders. They have the never give up mentality, and that's what I always like to see in any sport.
Benedict gets it up with ease. Finds Murder on the right wing. He's looking down low to Clark. Stay goes up top to Platt. Platt gets it to Benedict on the left wing for three, and that one splashes in.
Benedict made a three from the opposite side of the court in the same position, and he does it again here in the second half.
Sure, Benedict, such a dead eye for the Foresters. But just like that, you have DeJuan Williams saying, don't forget about me for Great Lakes, as he gets himself a three-point attempt.
I remember last year in one game, Drew Benedict made eight threes in a row, so he has plenty of potential in him.
Benedict has the ball there on the left wing, going down low on the block to Platt. Platt back out to Benedict at the top of the key for three, and that one's good. What a dead-eye shooter Drew Benedict is. Juan Williams bringing the ball up court now for the Crusaders. He's going to get it over to James. James going to take a few steps top of the key, takes the shot. It's not there. Benedict gets the rebound. He gets it up to Platt. Platt goes immediately for two and goes to the ground. Looks like he got fouled, but it's no good. Rebound by Murder as Clark gets it. He's going to try to swing, and it's not there.
Good Williams. Defense by the Crusaders as they number three scores for the and one.
That was a great job there by DeJuan Williams, getting himself another and one opportunity. That foul will go on Kyle Platt, and that'll be his second. It's Now we see Williams' free throw attempt up, and that is good. 84-48.
We saw Kyle Platt get some instruction from his father over here on the sidelines, and I think that's kind of a beneficial thing for a father and son on a coaching team, as when who do you look up to the most throughout your career in any athletic event, and that's your father. And it's a good thing for Platt to have his father on the sideline, because instead of looking into the stands of what to do, you can just look on the sidelines.
Definitely something great for that. Both of them great basketball players, and if Huntington's lucky enough, maybe Platt can turn himself into a Doug McDermott-type figure. Good father-son duo.
Exactly,
just a thought here for Huntington. We're going to see Colton inbound now to Williams. Williams being guarded by Platt. He's going to take him inside with his speed, and he will be fouled. Williams keeping this life alive for Great Lakes, and that foul's going to go on Drew Benedict.
Austin Clark, I believe. And Austin Clark's...
So that foul is on Austin Clark, his third, like you said, Victor. And that's the fifth foul on the Foresters.
And Austin Clark's kind of caught himself in a rut so far here in the second, as he's missed from three as well. He's missed three shots as well as now getting into foul trouble.
Inbound goes to Park. Park going to take a long three. That's no good. Rebound by Austin Clark. Now he's going to try to bring it up court, putting the moves on James. And he finally gets it up to Miller. Miller going to find Murder at the top of the key. He'll kind of try to slow things down, settle this offense.
Clark redeeming himself after the Crusaders with that full court press.
Benedict has Williams all over him, as now he's going to go to Platt on the left corner for three, and that one rims out. Rebound by Jalen James as he's going to push it for Great Lakes. He's going to find Williams down low. Williams dishes it out to Thomas. Thomas going to take a long two, and that's good. Platt looking for an inbound. He finds Miller.
Foresters can't get too excited, and they have to remember you have to inbound the ball in order to continue play.
Miller going to take a long three, and that one's good for Calvin Miller.
Hometown hero Calvin Miller, the crowd goes wild.
Dewan Williams takes it all the way in. He'll be fouled on the ground. This one will be on Drew Benedict. Foul on the ground, no shot, and that'll be his third. As now we have a mass substitution coming for the Foresters.
That's one advantage the Foresters have right now, being ahead by 37 points, is that they can just clear the bench and get fresh legs out in the court, which smells trouble for the Crusaders.
And for the Foresters will be Heinen, Wolf, Fode, Lockwood, and Lucas. And now we have another foul as Williams draws the foul on Heinen. That's his second. That's the team's seventh foul this half. So Great Lakes finds themselves in the bonus with 11:15 remaining in this ball game. They'll be shooting the 1-1. Williams' first attempt's up, and that's no good. Rebound by Wool.
Although the Crusaders are down by 37, as we stated, with the Foresters now getting into the bonus. The Crusaders getting into the bonus. That might be beneficial down the road, and who knows, we could see the Crusaders make a comeback.
We see Wool taking a strong to the rim, getting his own rebound, and he will be fouled. That foul will fall on Dana Thomas. That'll be his first foul of the ball game, as Wool earned himself two shots from the free throw line. First free throw attempts up. That one rims around and out. Didn't get the lucky bounce for Wool. And Wool's second free throw attempts up. Hits the back iron and out, no good. Now this will be Colton getting it up to Thomas. Thomas going to do a step back from the elbow. It's no good. Wool gets himself the rebound, though. Heinen getting it up court for the Foresters. Finds Lucas on the wing. Luke's going to go down low to Lockwood, throws it over. Couldn't quite get that one. Turnover for the Foresters.
Heinen almost with the steal.
Jalen James with the wide open three-point attempt from the corner. It's not there. And Lockwood and Wool fight for the ball, and that one will go out of bounds.
Looks like the Crusaders will do a clearing of their bench of their own right now, Logan.
87-50, the Foresters on top of the Great Lakes Crusaders, 10-24 remaining in this ball game. As it looks like they got some sweat on the ball, the referee will clean that off for our collegiate athletes.
You think at this time in history that someone would have come up with a sweat-proof ball. You know, Logan, I was watching Jimmy Fallon last night, and there was these great minds of young kids with this one invention. This little girl, I think she was about 4 years old, had the idea of putting peanut butter in a deodorant stick so that way you don't have to use a knife in order to make a PB&J. I think that is a fantastic idea. We have plenty of great minds out there, so I look for the future of having a ball that is sweat-proof.
So the future's looking bright for America is what you're telling me.
Absolutely, Logan.
You see Jeremy Lee missed front of the 1-1. Getting the rebound there was James. Now we have a long three-point attempt from Shelton, and Shelton gets that one to fall for Great Lakes. Derek Heinen bringing the ball up court for the Foresters. He's going to get to Lucas on the left wing. Down low to Fode. Great position down low. He's going to get it blocked by Bentley, but gets his own rebound. He's going to throw it out to Wool. Wool loses the ball, somehow manages to get it back. And he's going to Heinen right behind him. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Force is going to have to hurry. Screen there by Lockwood. Heinen going to take it in. No look pass. Fake pass. As he gets that one to fall.
It was a great fake by Mr. Derek Heinen, but earlier in the play, I liked how Mr. Kai Fode, he was trapped by the Crusaders, but able to get it out and keep the play alive for the Foresters.
Shelton going with the finger roll, it's not there. And Lucas wisely gets it back to Heinen. Lucas gets it on the right wing, goes down low to Lockwood. Lockwood giving it back to Lucas. Lucas gonna draw the foul there on Sam Anderson. There's nowhere for Anderson to go as Lockwood did a great job creating that foul.
Smart job.
So now we'll see Trevor Lucas going to the line to shoot a pair of free throws. Lucas looking to get himself here on the board. First free throw attempt's up and good. Lucas looking to convert on this second one. His second free throw attempt is up, and that is good. Splashing bottom of the net. And now we have a timeout on the court. Huntington Foresters lead 91-53 over the Great Lakes Crusaders. Victor, I know we've seen a lot that we've liked out of the starters of the Foresters, but what have you seen out of the bench that you've liked?
Well, as we've said, Logan, it's the freshmen that are stepping up for the Foresters here tonight with Kyle Platt and Devon Murder, Trevor Lockwood. I mean, just countless others that have shown why they are here on the Forester squad.
You're definitely right. These freshmen have come out strong. We've seen good chemistry also from the freshmen, and they seem to be working together nicely, hustling for boards. The big men, Clark and Locke, have done a great job. Platt's had a lot of intensity this second half. They haven't been leaving him open at all, though, for that three-point shot.
Yes, sir. Logan, a reminder that this timeout is brought to you by FDN News at FDN News on Twitter and Forrester Digital Network on Facebook. There are co-affiliates here at Huntington University. We cover sports, they cover news. It's been a great change of pace this year as we've established the Forrester Digital Network.
Forrester Digital Network has brought a whole new look here to Huntington University. As once again, and make sure we give you guys a reminder that not only does FDN Sports cover basketball, but also expanded to soccer and volleyball this year.
That was a fun job earlier in the year covering volleyball and soccer. I learned a thing or two while covering volleyball and soccer because usually I just focus on basketball and football.
As we get back to action now, we have a turnover right off the bat from Tommy Bentley, the sophomore from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. And we'll see Wool get the inbound from Lockwood. Hands off to Heinen in the backcourt. Heinen gets it up to Lucas on that right wing. Lucas going to Fode, has it knocked away. Gets it back to Wool. Wool to Heinen on the left wing, down low to Fode now. Fode looking for a pass. Going to go to Wool on the outside. Back down to Fode. Fode with a turnaround, Jay. It's not there. Rebound, Bentley. He throws it away to Heinen. Heinen being guarded by Danny Buger. He's all over him as Wool has it on the outside. Trying to pick up a screen from Lockwood. Instead, he'll drive into the right side. Pull up for two. Not there. Tipped around. Anderson comes up with it. He'll throw it out to Lee. Lee's going to get this one stolen by Trevor Lucas. As Lucas is trapped in the back. And now there'll be a foul called here on Jeremy Lee.
The fans were getting excited because freshman Trevor Lockwood, he was ready to lay it down once again here in the second.
As Nathan Schoen now will enter the game for Tommy Benton, Great Lakes. Lockwood set to inbound on the opposite side. He gets it into Heinen cleanly. Heinen finds Wool on the left wing. Picks up a screen on the left side from Lockwood. Wool going back up to Heinen on the right wing. Down low to Lockwood. Lockwood with the nice, so handoff to Heinen with the backdoor cut, and that's in.
Great ball movement by the Foresters. No one being selfish with the ball tonight.
Jeremy Lee bringing the ball up court for the Crusaders. Man-to-man defense still run by the Foresters. That's going to be Buger getting it back now to Lee. Heinen all over him. Wool guarded Shelton. Shelton with a long two. That's no good. Rebound Lucas. Heinen going to look up to Lucas. Lucas sees a lane. He's going to take it in for two. Not there. Lockwood with the easy rebound. Up and in. Now it's going to be Jeremy Lee doing the main ball handling duties. Finds Anderson on the left side. Thought about shooting. Throws it back out now to James. James goes to Lee. Lee back to James on that left side. German right now. Shelton gets it at the top of the key. And now there's going to be a foul called on the play as Jeremy Lee went driving in. This foul's going to be on Derek Heinen. As we have a pair of substitutions for the Foresters. It'll be Austin Clark coming in for Dan Wool and Tyler Ault coming in for Derek Heinen.
It's nice to see senior Tyler Ault back on the court for the Foresters.
And a full bench clearing almost here for Great Lakes. It looks like Jeremy Lee will be set to leave after his free throw attempts. Lees will bank in the front end of the 1-1. I think everyone's a little surprised. It's a little late for the bank to be open tonight. As we're going to see Jeremy Lee looks tack on the back half of this 1-1. It's up. And that one rims around and out. The ball doesn't lie. Ault will get it and bring it up court for Huntington.
This is going to be extremely cheesy, Logan, but he's going to have to cash in his deposit tomorrow.
Lucas getting the give and go from Clark. Can't quite handle it. Still feisty about it. As you're going to say, Lucas hit it out of bounds. It's going to be Great Lakes ball. Dewan Williams now inbounding to Thomas. Thomas going to give it right back to Williams. Lucas has the duties of guarding him as Williams goes right at him. It's no good. Rebound Lockwood. Ault going to get it up to Lucas. Lucas looking to press. He's going to go down low to Clark. Clark with the give and go to Lucas. Lucas with the left-handed layup. Nice job there by the freshman.
Once again, Logan, I have to say, what is happening tonight is very reminiscent of street backyard ball, and I am loving it.
James looking to go in. Lockwood getting a hand on it. Gets it out to Parks. Parks going to go now to Colton. It's not there. Ault going to bring it up court for the Foresters and slow things down. Ault has it poked away by Dewan Williams there. But it's going to be an over and back call on Tyler Ault. As now we see Peterson come in the game for Lockwood and Pippinger coming in for Fode as they get a nice standing ovation.
I just have to say again, Logan, that in the past, ever since I was a freshman, we didn't have very many fans on opening day here in Platt Arena, the newly named Platt Arena. Back then it wasn't called that. And it's nice to see how many fans are out in support for the Foresters. And I think it's due in part because of the success we had last year. We had both our teams, both men's and women's, went to nationals, as well as the tremendous effort by Shane Merriman and was able to get the winning shot against Marion at the time and on SportsCenter. I mean, I think that just created a buzz here on campus that basketball is back and it's the sport that we need to show our support for.
The Foresters, like you said, started out strong last season, started out 14-0, finished the season 24-8. Great season for them. Like I said, rejuvenated this whole campus and all the alum to get back out to this game.
And it's nice we're able to broadcast the games now here on FDN Sports because we're able to keep the alums informed.
Most definitely. We see Alt inbounding to Pippinger. Pippinger with a little fake goes up for two, and he is fouled. So Pippinger earns himself another trip to the free throw line to shoot two. That foul will be on DeJuan Williams. That will be his fourth foul. So the leading scorer for Great Lakes has four fouls and has to be in the back of his mind with 5:29 remaining in this ballgame. Pippinger's first free throw attempts up. Silky smooth, right to the bottom of the net.
Silky smooth like a Milky Way.
Milky Way's being passed out tonight probably for trick or treat. A lot of little kids are probably getting Milky Ways.
When I get back into my room, I know that I'm going to devour some candy. Let me tell you what. This is the first Halloween that I have not been at the dentist since I can remember. Now, can you explain that, Logan? Almost every Halloween I've gone to the dentist, and I just don't understand that. It's an oxymoron.
Dennis always keeping watch on you. As we see, Lucas getting up court, has the breakaway. He's going to pull up for two. Banks it off the glass. A nice play there by Trevor Lucas, the freshman, as the Foresters break the 100 mark now. We're going to see a long three by James. Misfired there. Rebound by Peterson. As Peterson gets it taken away by James. And Peterson gets it to Lucas. Now full court press by Great Lakes. Lucas going to try to dribble out of it. And Lucas and Peterson taking each other down. All going to somehow come up with that ball. And now we're going to have a hand check called by Jalen James. And now we're going to have a few substitutions now for the Foresters. We see Alt, Peterson, and Pippinger all take a seat. Lockwood, Platt, and Murder all in. So we see all five freshmen in the ballgame with 4:38 remaining. Platt inbounds to Murder. Murder dribbling baseline, gets it back to Platt. Platt to Murder, left side corner for three. That's no good. Murder gets his own rebound, tries to take it in. And Williams now has a fast break. So he goes up and puts that in for two.
I could see number three's eyes. Looks like he was sizing up number one for the Foresters. And he was like, oh, I can take it. I can take it. I don't think he would have taken it if the likes of Trevor Lockwood or Alec Peterson were there to block him, though.
That is definitely true. So we see Lucas taking it inside, gets it to Clark. Clark up and good for two himself as Williams trying to push it for Great Lakes. Lucas going to meet him there on defense. As now we will have a timeout called, 30-second timeout called by the Great Lakes Crusaders with 3:54 remaining. The Huntington University Foresters on top of this one, 103-62.
That is a tremendous gap that the Great Lakes has kind of dug themselves in here tonight in Platt Arena. But it's early in the season, and it's a great prospect. It's a great experience for Great Lakes to face a good Crossroads team like the Foresters. And mentioning the Crossroads League, other night the Crusaders faced Spring Arbor, so they've definitely gotten their fair share of Crossroads League action. And a reminder to follow FDN Sports on Twitter at FDN Sports. I've been tweeting the whole game with some updates if you cannot watch the game, as well as follow us on Facebook, Forster Digital Network.
We see the inbound now for Great Lakes. It's going to be Thomas, top of the key, getting it to Williams on the left side. Parks thought about taking the long three. Lockwood out there with him, though. Thomas going to go inside on Clark. Lockwood getting the miss. Murder going to bring it up court quickly for the Foresters. Platt thought about going down low. It's not there. Lucas now getting the ball on the right wing, looking for Clark. Finds Platt at the top of the key for three, and that is good.
Kyle Platt hitting his second three of the game. Like I've said before, hitting threes, rebounding, blocking, this kid can do it all.
Did it in high school, and he's taking his talents, you know, about 3 minutes down the road and doing it right here in this gym, Platt Arena. Park's going to take a long three, and he answers himself. That's a high point there for Parks. We see Platt getting the inbound. And Platt's going to bring it up himself before finally dishing it off to Murder. Murder going to find Lucas on the right wing. Lucas lofts it over to Lockwood. Lockwood put that one up and in. Nice play there by the two freshmen.
Besides the hustle we've seen out of the Foresters here tonight, Logan, they've done a great job of passing the ball and communication, which I've seen often that teams don't have. So it's nice to see early in the season them getting the communication down.
Colton with the missed three. Lucas comes with the rebound, has it poked away though. And now we see a loose ball. Man, it looks like it's gonna be a jump ball now. Possession error going to the Foresters. And we see Juan Williams, excuse me, exiting the ballgame. In for him would be Nathan Shelton. As now Murder brings the ball up court for the Foresters. 2:20 remaining in this ballgame. Murder finds Lucas on the right wing. Dribble penetration not there. Gets it to Clark. Clark going to go back to Lucas now. Lucas swings it to Murder. Murder going to go to Platt in the left corner for three. And that rims out. Rebound by Lucas. Lucas goes for the foul. It's not there. He's going to miss that one. And Clark going to get the rebound off the steal. Looked like he may have gotten fouled. Goes to the ground. It's not there. Parks bringing it up court. No look pass. Borger gets it to Shelton. And that's two.
I appreciate the effort the Foresters just showed on the court, but I think this late in the game and by ahead this much, I think they, don't get hurt is my message to them. Just don't get hurt. We've seen Austin Clark limping a little bit. We don't need any injuries this early in the season.
Lockwood getting himself a nice mid-range jumper with the assist from Austin Clark. Foresters still rolling with a minute 20 remaining. Park going to get it down to Thomas. Thomas going to try to go off the glass. It's not there. Murder with the rebound. And Murder gets it up court. Going to get the screen from Clark. Going to play a little ring around the rosy now. Is he going to pull it back out? And the Foresters look content with running this shot clock down, trying to shorten this ball game. So Lockwood's going to get at the free throw line. Murder going to take it in himself. Going to miss the layup. Just couldn't quite get the roll off the glass. Rebound by Parks. He gets it up to Thomas now. Thomas brings it on the right side. Tries taking it on Lucas. Not there. Going to go to Colton. Colton with the mid-range. It's not there. Trevor Lucas gets the rebound. And Murder gets it to Platt. And Platt's going to hold the ball here near center court. Going to dribble out of the 5 second count as he passes it off to Lucas. Lucas up to Platt. Platt gets it to Lucas. Lucas goes to Lockwood at the three. Lucas goes to Platt. Platt from the corner, and he gets the three. With 1 second remaining, why not?
Kyle Platt putting the exclamation mark on his great performance here tonight. That is three threes from him.
Kyle Platt just going out with a bang as we see the Huntington University Foresters taking this one 113-67.
We are FDN Sports on the Forester Digital Network. We'll take a quick break and be right back with the post-game wrap-up.
Great Lakes Christian College versus the University of St. Francis and Hey, guys. You good?
And we're back here on the Forrester Digital Network, FDN Sports, after this great win by the Forresters facing the Crusaders, 113-67. Joining us at the table is Coach Platt. Coach Platt, first off, how was it coaching your son in the first game of the season? And secondly, how do you think the Forresters' performance will allude to the season?
I guess I'll start with your first question. Coaching Kyle is going to be a joy. I mean, it's I'm sure it's going to have its ups and downs and all those kinds of things, but it's something that we've dreamed about doing. But actually, when the game is going on and all those kinds of things, he's just another player in a lot of ways. I mean, I'm not going to say that he's just another player, I mean, all the time or whatever, because he is my kid, but I want him to do well, just like I want all of our guys to do well and perform the way he's supposed to, and all of our guys. So it's a joy that way. It's a good win for us, though, to start the year and all that. But we also know that there's going to be a lot of teams that are stronger than what Great Lakes is. And as far as I'm concerned, once we're done having this interview, this game's pretty much over. It's about now getting ready for the next one. I didn't do a very good job of scheduling games in terms of early on here, giving us a chance to get rest or maybe even get a few more practices in before we play. We play not only tomorrow, but then Monday and Wednesday and Saturday of next week. And so it just kind of gets rolling. We've got a lot of things to work on. We've got a lot of things to do better. But I like our depth. I like our young guys. And it's just going to be a work in progress. And we'll just see what tomorrow brings.
Touching on the freshman, going back to Kyle Platt real quick, we saw him. He could do it all tonight. He hit three from the three-point line, as well as blocks and rebounds. But speaking of the whole freshman squad,
right.
Very promising in their first outing.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, you look at guys like, Trevor Lockwood's a big, tall kid who has a good instinct about him. He can shoot it some. And I think he's going to be a special player. Devin Murders, same thing. He's a guy that he kind of hung on to the ball a little too much tonight at different times. But this is their first college game, and so I think he's going to be a real special player. Trevor Lucas is another guy. He's athletic as all get out and understands the game and can do some things with his athleticism that other guys can't. And I think he's going to be really good as well. And then Austin. Austin Clark is a big, strong kid that we're going to need a lot of minutes out of this year because – he can play both the four and the five-man spot. He can rebound and is a guy that's very, very coachable and it's just going to get better and better. So, we like all of our guys, but the young guys, as you said, are going to be a special group, I think, in time.
It was something special to see Trevor Lockwood slamming it down early in the first. I mentioned to my comrade Logan here that it was the first time I saw a slam dunk in the opening game in quite some time. But that got the fans into the game. So let's touch on the fans for just a moment. It was a great outing by the fans. I love seeing the support that they have shown after a successful season that you guys had last year and them continuing that going forward.
Oh, yeah. We definitely will always have a great adult following. We just want to keep the students growing and growing. I really appreciate them being here. It wasn't the greatest environment in terms of being able to, it's not a nip and tuck game and, big plays and send it into, whatever, but those will come. We know that. I mean, those kinds of games are going to be right around the corner and as early as maybe tomorrow or Monday, so we definitely need our fan base and we appreciate them greatly and we want the students to support each other, not just men's basketball, but all of our sports and all of our activities. And so, hey, we're HU. We're not just HU men's basketball, and that's really cool. So, I don't know. We'll see what tomorrow brings.
Amen, Coach. Well, thank you, Coach Platt, and treating us here on this Halloween night for the Forresters winning 113-67 against the Great Lakes Christian College Crusaders. Logan, any final words?
It was a great showing by the whole HU squad, as Coach Platt said. And particularly, like I said, the freshmen came out hot. But that starting five, it was very seasoned. A lot of those guys played minutes. They came out and really set the tone for the four, so that was great to see.
Well, for our director and our crew, I am Victor McCarty speaking for my partner, Logan Hunt. This has been FDN Sports on the Forrester Digital Network. We'll see you tomorrow at 3 o'clock as the Forresters continue in the Forrester Classic against the Ohio Midwestern College.